will be done by an old artist who is 60 years of age, right? So a very good evening to everyone. Today we are going to start a new chapter from your book Moments, and that entitled The Last Leaf, written by Sydney Potter, right? And better nickname, better known by his pen name O. Henry, right? The Last Leaf comes up with a very strong message of selflessness and the spirit of sacrifice. This chapter is guided with the spirit of sacrifice that we should do. And this is done by a 60-year-old artist, a painter he was, when he sacrificed his life. And O. Henry, as he is known for the surprise element at the end of the chapter. When you will go through this at the end, definitely you are going to have the surprise at the end. And definitely this story comes up with another strong message, and that is hope to live. We should always remain positive in life. We should eliminate all kind of negativity that occurs to us at any point of time in our life. We can go through thick and thin. We can have various adverse circumstances in our life, but should we surrender to them? Should we reconcile to our fate, or should we fight back? Yes, Kartikeya, what do you think? We should fight back, or we should just accept it? Yes, we are destined for it. What do you say?
Ma'am, we should fight back.
Definitely. And fight is the spirit that guides our life. And the biggest fighter have always been the biggest winners in life. And so this story is going to tell you, eliminate negativity from your life and welcome new hope. And hope can be received from anything, right? It can be from anything. The thing is that, the motive is that you should know how to guide your life. So let's start our chapter today, The Last Leaf. It is autumn season. What happens usually, Akshabra, in autumn season? What happens in autumn season? Anyone? Kushal? Don't write in the chat. We want you people to answer it. Kushal, your mic works very nicely. What happens in autumn season? Yes. You are writing in the chat. Aksha has also written in the chat, and Darshil has also written. The trees shed their leaves, right? Autumn season, the basic characteristic of autumn season is that the trees shed their leaves. The wind is blowing hard and it is raining heavily. Tez hawa chal rahi hai, right? It is raining hard. All the leaves on an...
I have also written in the chat box only.
I know Kushal will also write. But you, now also you are speaking now. You should tell that. Right? Okay. Yes. Okay. Ivy creeper tha, all the leaves on an ivy creeper have fallen. A creeper tha, from which every leaf has fallen except one. Only the last one was left. And from here, the title of the chapter has been taken. Why doesn't the last leaf fall? The question for you all is that, why doesn't that last leaf fall? Let's read and find out what happened. Sue and John C, two young artists. This is story of two friends. They are Sue and John C. They were the two young artists, shared a small flat. They were both living in a small flat. The flat was on the third story of an old house. Ek aur purana ghar tha, uski third story par, third level par, they were living. John C fell very seriously in November. It was the month of November, autumn season. And she fell seriously in. She had pneumonia. Start of the winter. She had extreme pneumonia, and she would lie in her bed without moving. And what had become her routine, that she used to lie in her bed without moving, hilti nahi thi. Right? She kept on lying and just gazing out of the window. And for the whole day, she was just gazing out of the window. Right? Just lying on the bed and gazing out of the window. You can see, I just show you that also in this way. See, you can see this is the creeper. This is the ivy creeper. You can see these leaves, right? And she is just lying on the bed and looking out. This is Sue and this is Chauncey, right? So she is just sitting there and looking out. सू हर फ्रेंड बिकेम वेरी वरीड, और जो सू थी वो काफी वरीड हो गई. जॉनसी, सॉरी जॉनसी फेलियर एंड सू बीमार हो गई थी काफी. सू हर फ्रेंड बिकेम वेरी वरीड, सो जो सू थी वो काफी वरीड हो गई अपनी फ्रेंड जॉनसी को लेकर. शी सेंट फॉर द डॉक्टर, उसने डॉक्टर को बुलाया, एंड बिकॉज इट इज द यूजुअल थिंग दैट वी डू, जॉनसी हैज फॉलन इल, सो सू बिकॉज शी वॉज गेटिंग टू मच वरीड. And she called doctor to look after, to see what is the reason with Jonesy. Although he came every day, although he is the doctor. Doctor aate the her rose, there was no change in Jonesy's condition. But Jonesy was not recovering. She was showing no sign of recovery. One day the doctor took Sue aside and asked her. Sue ko side mein le jaakar, usually it is the habit of the doctor that in front of the patients, they don't reveal his on her exact situation. And they say, ki, usse bolte hain, Sue say, is anything worrying Jonesy? Just let me know if anything is there that she has any cause of worry with her, ki kya problem, kya hai, kyun wo itna pareshan ho rahi hai? Means what is the reason, ki, why she is not responding actually. The thing is that she is not responding to the medicines. Something is worried, means some psychological factor is working behind. No, replied Sue, Sue ne ka nahi, but why do you ask? आप ऐसा क्यों बोल रहे हो? देयर इज नथिंग लाइक दैट. ऐसा तो कोई बोन ऑफ वरी नहीं है उसकी लाइफ में. तो व्हाट देन द डॉक्टर सेड, जॉनसी इट सीम्स हैज मेड अप हर माइंड. सो एज वी डिस्कस्ड एट द स्टार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर, कि ऐसा लगता है कि शी हैज गिवन अप द फाइट, राइट? सो शी हैज मेड अप हर माइंड दैट शी इज नॉट गोइंग टू गेट वेल. एंड व्हेन द साइकोलॉजी टर्न्स अप नेगेटिव, देन डेफिनेटली इवन द डॉक्टर्स कांट डू एनीथिंग. You know, will to live is the positive energy that is created in the body of the patient when they are treated. Only the medicines don't work. It is always the combination of medicines and prayers and your willpower that fight with any kind of infection that occurs or that infects our body. So, if she doesn't want to live, doctor ne kaha, aisa lagta hai ki she is mentally prepared to give up. And if she doesn't want to live, or agar wo khud hi nahi jeena chahti hai, then medicines will not help her. Sue tried her best to make Jonesy take an interest in things around her. Sue ne kaafi koshish ki, kyunki Jonesy ki bahut achhi dost thi, dosti ki kahani bhi bahut achhi hai, that you can learn the things from this chapter also, that how you should carry forward your friendship. So she tried her best ki, to make Jonesy comfortable, to inculcate a will to live in her. And interested ki wo cheeze jo aas paas hai usme interest lena shuru kare, like that she talked about clothes and fashions. Wo baatein karti thi ki uska mind divert karne ke liye, her intention was to distract her mind from her illness. So Sue used to talk about clothes and fashions, but Jonesy did not respond. Jonesy continued to lie still on her bed. Wo waise hi wo still she used to lie. Sue brought her drawing board into Jonesy's room just to add colors to her life. Jonesy did some brought a drawing board, ek drawing board lekar aayi into Jonesy's room and started painting to take Jonesy's mind off her illness, taki Jonesy ka mind jo hai wo apni illness se distract kar sake, divert kar sake, to divert her attention. Suddenly Sue heard Jonesy whisper something. Suddenly what happened while she was painting, that something happened. She is doing something. She is saying something. Then Jonesy was doing this, and Sue heard this, and she became like, what she is doing? She quickly rushed to the bed and heard Jonesy counting backwards. उसने देखा Jonesy जो है वो backward counting कर रही है. She was looking out of the window and was saying, she was looking window के बाहर देख रही थी, and she was saying something. 12. After some time, she whispered 11. Then 10. Then 9, 8, 7. So backward counting, actually in this sequence, the leaves were falling, right? Ivy creeper used to lose all its leaves in the autumn season, but she had somehow associated it with her life. So Sue anxiously looked out of the window. Anxiously means curiously. And whispered means spoke in a low voice. So anxiously, उसने curiously बाहर देखा कि ये देख क्या रही है और क्या काउंट कर रही है. She saw an old ivy creeper climbing halfway up the brick wall. Brick wall, as I showed you in the picture at the start of the chapter, कि ब्रिक वॉल के ऑपोजिट जो थी उनकी विंडो थी वहां पर एक क्रीपर है, ईवी क्रीपर है, दैट इज हाफ वे अप द ब्रिक वॉल. इन द स्ट्रॉन्ग विंड आउटसाइड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग गेल्स वर ब्लोइंग आउटसाइड, सो द क्रीपर वॉज शेडिंग इट लीव्स, इट्स लीव्स, और ये बहुत नेचुरल था कि जो ईवी क्रीपर था इट वॉज शेडिंग इट्स लीव्स. वॉट इज इट डियर, शी सू आस्क्ड, उन्हें पूछा डियर, सो शी बिकेम वरीड कि वॉट इज इट सू, वट आर यू डूइंग. Six, whispered Johnsy. Johnsy ne dheere se bola, six. They are falling faster now. Now the leaves are falling in a quick, rapid rate. 3 days ago, there were almost 100 leaves. So 3 days earlier, 100 leaves the. Means within 3 days, around 100 leaves have fallen. Now there are only 5 left. It is autumn. So Sue tried to convince Johnsy, doesn't get associated with the shedding of leaves now. It is autumn season and the leaves will fall. It is a very natural factor. So it's a natural thing that used to happen. When the last leaf falls, I will die. Ab Johnsy actually now told her what she was thinking and what was the thing that doctor was also trying to find out, ki what negativity had entered into the mind of Johnsy. Then Johnsy came with finality. Finality means determination. Very conviction aap keh lijiye yahan par, not determination. We will call it ki strong belief, right? Conviction ke saath she said, I have known this for the last 3 days. So, mujhe maloom hai last 3 days se it is happening. Oh, that's nonsense. Sorry, I missed out one line. When the last leaf falls, and the leaves will fall, jab tune samjhaya usko Johnsy ko, ki don't go for that. Leaves to girenge hi, tum kyun aisa kar rahe ho? When the last leaf falls, I will die. And this is the negativity. This is the negativity the doctor was talking about. Even the last leaf falls, I will also die, said Johnsy with conviction. Strong belief ke saath, Johnsy told her, ki jab last leaf bhi gir jayega, to I will die. I have known this for the last 3 days. Or last 3 days se I knew means last 72 hours, I am cruising towards death. I am moving towards the end of my life. Oh, that's nonsense. So, now she became very angry and she says, you are talking nonsense. What have old ivy leaves to do with your getting well? Kya connection hai tumhara ivy leaves ke saath tumhare cheek hone mein? The doctor is confident that you will get better. Doctor is saying that you will, he is very confident regarding his treatment that you will get better very soon. Johnsy didn't say anything. Sue went and brought her a bowl of soup. So Johnsy didn't answer. In her heart, she had already made up her mind that she was going to die. So went and a bowl of soup uske liye lekar aayi. Right? I don't want any soup now because it was the last leaf that was left in the creeper. Now Johnsy had made up her mind that it is going to happen. So she simply straight away said no to the soup and said, I'm not hungry. I'm not interested in eating anything. Now there are only 4 leaves left. I want to see the last one fall before it gets dark. और मुझे पता है आज शाम होने से पहले ही द लास्ट लीव विल फॉल एंड आई विल ऑल्सो लीव दिस वर्ल्ड आई वॉन्ट टू सी सो देन आई विल स्लीप फॉर एवर एंड हियर शी सेज दैट देन दैट विल द एंड ऑफ माई लाइफ एंड आई विल स्लीप फॉर एवर सू सेट ऑन जॉनसीज बेड अब सू बिकेम वेरी वरीड अपनी फ्रेंड को लेकर शी बिकेम वेरी वरीड एंड उसको किस किया उसने Right? So sat on Johnsy's bed, kissed her and said, you are not going to die. Aap nahi marne wale ho. I can't draw the curtain for I need the light. Main yahan curtain bhi nahi kar sakti kyunki mujhe light ki need hai and light was coming from the street light. So I could not draw the curtain. I want to finish the painting and get some money for us. Mujhe painting banani hai aur kuch money I need because they both were the painters and they had hired this flat in London. So they used to sell their paintings and get some money. Please, my dear. And she said, please, my dear friend. She begged Johnsy. Sue ne Johnsy's request kiya, promise not to look out of the window while I paint. Ki jab main bahar dekhungi, to please aap. So, aap please count nahi karoge. Right? So, promise not to look or dekhoge bhi nahi while I am painting because I need to finish this painting. All right, Johnsy said, I finish your painting soon for I want to see the last leaf fall. उसने कहा ठीक है आप जल्दी से अपनी पेंटिंग को फिनिश कर लो क्योंकि मुझे लास्ट लीफ फॉल होते हुए देखना है. इट विल डेफिनेटली फॉल डन. आई एम टायर्ड ऑफ वेटिंग. नाउ आई एम सीरियसली फॉर द लास्ट 3 days आई एम वेटिंग एंड नाउ आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू वेट. राइट, अब मुझे वेट नहीं करना है, मेरे को देखना है कि दिस लीफ शुड फॉल एंड आई विल ऑल्सो लीव. आई एम टायर्ड ऑफ वेटिंग, आई हैव टू डाई, सो लेट मी गो अवे पीसफुली. आई हैव टू डाई, मुझे तो मरना ही है. राइट, आई हैव टू डाई एंड सो लेट मी गो अवे पीसफुली, मुझे यहाँ से आई लेट मी डिपार्ट पीसफुली. लाइक वन ऑफ दोस पुअर टायर्ड लीव्स, एज दीज पुअर लीव्स आर फॉलिंग वन आफ्टर अनदर एंड दे आर लीविंग दिस वर्ल्ड इन द सेम वे, आई विल ऑल्सो लीव. ट्राई टू स्लीप. अब सू बिकेम वेरी वरीड. Then she tried to make Chauncey comfortable and said that please Sue, try to sleep. I have to paint an old miner. Abhi main jo painting bana rahi hu wo ek old miner ki hai. That is the project she had got. So she needed to paint that. I'll call Berman to be my model. And mujhe ek old miner ki painting banani hai. To mere ko model chahiye because I need some inspiration. Someone so watching him, I could paint my painting. I could paint the picture. So I'm going to call Berman. So मैं Berman को बुलाने जा रही हूँ. She rushed down, वो भागी. Berman lived on the ground floor, in the same building. Mr. Berman used to live on the ground floor. He was a 60-year-old painter. His lifelong dream was to paint a masterpiece. But he had remained. वो masterpiece paint करना चाहता था. वो भी painter था और lifelong dream था. Paint a masterpiece. Masterpiece means a painting for which the person is known. एक ऐसी चीज जिसके लिए वो पूरी life में पूरी दुनिया में famous हो. So masterpiece paint करना चाहता था. But that had remained a dream. But till date it had not been completed. Sue poured out her worries to Berman. Poured out her worries means spoke everything to Mr. Berman that this is happening with us. Chauncey has lost all her hope to live. And I really wanted that she should live, and this negativity is not letting her live. And if the last leaf falls, it is sure that Chauncey may also lose her life. She told him how Chauncey was convinced that she would die when the last leaf falls. Is she stupid? Mr. Berman was shocked to listen. She's stupid? How can she be so foolish? How can she talk so foolishly? She is running a high temperature, complained Sue. Sue ne kaha, she is running a high temperature. Fever hai. Sue refuses to eat. She refuses to eat or drink, and that worries me a lot. So neither she is eating nor she is drinking, and that is adding to my worries. Obviously, meri mushkilein jo hai wo badh rahi hai, and I am really getting worried about her health. So I'll come with you and see Chauncey. Theek hai, I'm coming with you and I'll see Chauncey, Berman said. They tiptoed into the room. Tiptoed means walked with a very low voice. Walked in with a very low voice. ऐसे चीये धीरे चल के जाना. They tiptoed into the room. Chauncey was sleeping and Chauncey जो थी, she was sleeping there. And Sue drew the curtains together and they went to the next room. Sue ने curtain बंद कर दिया उस window का और वो next room में चले गए. She peeped out through the window. उसने room बाहर देखा विंडो के. देयर वाज ओनली वन लीफ ऑन द क्रीपर. प्रीवियसली 6 वर देयर एंड नाउ ओनली वन वाज लेफ्ट. इट वाज रेनिंग हेवीली एंड आइसी कोल्ड विंड वाज ब्लोइंग. बहुत तेज बारिश हो रही थी. आइसी विंड वाज ब्लोइंग एंड वेरी कोल्ड आइसी. नवंबर के मंथ में अगर बारिश होती है तो यू नो इट कि द वेरी कोल्ड विंड यूज्ड टू ब्लो. इट सीम्ड एज दो द लीफ वुड फॉल एंड दिस इज द यू कैन सी मिस्टर बर्मन. सो there was only one leaf in the creeper. बहुत icy wind चल रहा था. It seemed as though the leaf would fall any minute now. और ये clear था कि any minute the leaf would fall. Berman did not say a word. Berman ने कुछ नहीं कहा. He had decided something. Right? He went back to his room and he went back. Chauncey woke up next morning. अगली सुबह उठी and in a feeble voice. Feeble means very weak. Very weak. वॉइस पे उसने बोला. शी आस्क्ड सू टू ड्रॉ द कर्टेन्स. कहा कि कर्टेन्स को ओपन कर दो. एंड सू वाज नर्वस. सू बहुत नर्वस थी. राइट, बिकॉज़ शी न्यू कि इफ Chauncey वुड सी देयर इज नो लीफ लेफ्ट ऑन द इवी क्रीपर एंड दैट इज वेरी लाइकली दैट द स्ट्रॉन्ग विंड्स व्हिच वर ब्लोइंग लास्ट नाइट वुड हैव नॉट लेट दैट लीफ survive. So it was quite expected that the leap would not be there. So she drew back the curtains very reluctantly. Reluctantly means unwillingly. Dil nahi tha uska, but she had to draw the curtains. So usne khole, hata diye curtains ko hataya. Oh, Sue exclaimed as she looked at the vine creeper. Jab usne vine creeper ko dekha, wow! She, it was, she is the exclamation. Sudden outcome of Phoenix, look, there is still one leaf. Dekho, abhi bhi, one leaf is there on the creeper. It looks quite green and healthy, or bahut green aur healthy lag rahi hai. In spite of the storm and fierce winds, strong tha raat, storm aaya tha, in spite of the storm and the fires, again the strong winds, very strong winds, ke baad bhi, it did not fall. Ye giri nahi hai, fires means strong, and it did not fall. I heard the wind last night. Mera last night sun rahi thi awaazein. I thought it would have fallen. And I was not expecting that leaf would have survived. It will surely fall today, then I will die. Then John C, because she was just waiting for that, ki ye to hoga hi, ki ye jayegi leaf jo hai, definitely it will fall down. So he said, ki surely fall today, aaj ye pakka gir jayegi, and then I will die. You won't die, Sue ne energetically kaha. Energetically means enthusiastically, she said. You have to live for your friends. Aapko jeena hoga. You have to live for your friends. What would happen to me if you die? Don't you think that? Ki if you would die, then what I would do? John C. smiled weakly and closed her eyes. John C. thoda smile kiya, and that was the first smile, as we have read this chapter. It is her first smile, and she closed her eyes, thought about it. After every hour or so, she would look out of the window. But every hour, frequently, she was looking out of the window and find the leaves still there. And leaf was still there. It seemed to be clinging to the creeper. Clinging means holding tightly. Right? Holding tightly. Aisa lag raha tha, kaske jo hai, leaf ne pakad ke rakha hua hai creeper ko. In the evening, there was another storm. Sham ko phir tufaan aaya. But the leaf did not fall. Still leaf survived. John C. lay for a long time looking at the leaf. And John C. was lying there. She was continuously looking at the leaf. Then she called out to Sue. After usne Sue ko bulaya, I have been a bad girl. Now she realized, if this last leaf can survive through the storm, then I cannot fight back to my illness. Can I not recover? That was a question to herself. To herself, she asked this. So why I am surrendering when this single leaf is fighting, continuously fighting with the storms. So I have been a bad girl. Then she realized her mistake. Yes, I have been a very bad girl. You have looked after me so lovingly, and I have not cooperated with you. Aapne mere ko itna care kiya, right? You looked after me, and all the time you were there with me whenever I needed, but I didn't support you. I have been depressed and gloomy. Main depressed thi. I have been gloomy. Gloomy means sad. Hoon main is baat ko lekar, that I was all the time going against all your consolations. I was not listening to that. The last leaf has shown me how wicked I have been. Aur ye last leaf ne mujhe dikha diya ki main kitni wicked thi. Right? I have been very wicked, and I have realized that it is a sin to want to die. So wicked means bad person. And I have realized, and finally mujhe realize ho chuka hai, that it is a sin to want to die. And those who do not care for their life, definitely they are the evilsome people. They are going against the God. Kyunki God has given us life to live, not to take it back. We have no right over our life. God has already decided when we are supposed to enter into this world and when we have to depart. So we should not interfere into the law of nature. Let God do, let nature do whatever its work is, whatever his work is, and we should do our deeds, and rather good deeds and the duties which are assigned to us, the responsibilities that fall on our shoulder, and the most important thing, we should follow the virtues, the human virtues in our life. So she hugged John C. Sue realized it, and she hugged John C. Usne hug kiya, right? And then she gave her lots of hot soup. और फिर इसने बहुत सारा हॉट सूप पिया एंड एक मिरर लेकर आई राइट So Jhansi combed her hair and smiled brightly. Now she was full of, she was filled with positivity. Now she had come back to life. She had drifted back towards life again. In the afternoon, the doctor came. After examining his patient, he told Sue, Jhansi now has the will to live. So doctor had already realized that when will to live nahi hoga, Jhansi could not recover. So examine karne ke baad usne bola ki I am confident she'll recover soon and very soon she will be all right. Now I must go downwards, downstairs and see Berman. Abhi mujhe abhi niche jana hai. Mr. Berman is not well. He is also suffering from pneumonia. So he pneumonia ho gaya, but I'm afraid there is no hope for him. But I'm afraid he is not going to survive. He's a 60-year-old man and this pneumonia is not going to spare him. The next morning, Sue came. And agli subah jab Sue aayi, then sat on Jhansi's bed. Jhansi ke bed par baithi. And taking Jhansi's hand in his in hers, she said, Jhansi ke haath pakad kar, she said, I have something to tell you. Mujhe aapko kuch batana hai. And what is it? I want to tell you something. Mr. Berman died of pneumonia this morning. Pneumonia, who was suffering with pneumonia? With it? Who was suffering from pneumonia? Vidit? Who was suffering? Chat me likhenge. Please tell.
Ma'am, may I tell?
Yeah, please tell.
Mr. Berman.
Mr. Berman was suffering before. Mr. Berman, who was suffering from pneumonia?
Jhansi.
Jhansi, very good. Jhansi was suffering with pneumonia. Now, Mr. Berman was suffering. She had started recovering because of that ivy leaf, right? Ivy creeper par jo leaf tha, because of that she had been surviving. So in the afternoon, it happened ki Mr. Morning mein jab wo aayi next morning, then she told Sue told Jhansi that Mr. Berman died of pneumonia this morning. He was ill only for 2 days. Sirf 2 days. He was ill for 2 days. 2 days se wo bimar the. The first day, the janitor found him on his bed. Janitor is the attendant one who takes care of. Jo caretaker unke ghar par tha, usne dekha unko bed par. His clothes and shoes were wet. Wo barish mein, kyunki the day before yesterday also it was storm and heavy raining. It was raining very heavily. So the first day, janitor found him on his bed. So jo caretaker tha, usne usse bed par dekha. His clothes and shoes were wet. Shoes and clothes dono bheeg chuke the and he was shivering. He was shivering with cold. Shivering means trembling. Trembling with cold. He had been out in that stormy night. And the day before yesterday evening, it was totally stormy outside and cold wind, icy winds were blowing and he went outside. They had then they found a ladder and a lantern still lighted lying near his bed. And then unko ek ladder mili unke flat par. Ek lantern thi. Lantern is a lamp. Still lighted lying near his bed. Uske bed ke paas hi wo lantern thi. So there was also, there were also some brushes. Kuch brushes the, green and yellow paints the on the floor near the ladder. Ladder ke paas hi green or yellow color ke paints bhi the. Jhansi dear, Sue ne kaha, look out of the window. उस विंडो के बाहर देखो व्हाट यू कैन सी लुक एट दैट इवी लीफ हैवंट यू वंडर्ड व्हाई इट डज नॉट फ्लटर व्हेन द विंड ब्लोस सो हैवंट यू वंडर्ड सोचा नहीं तुमने कभी कि व्हाई इट डिड नॉट मूव फ्लटर मींस मूव क्यों नहीं कर रही है व्हेन द विंड ब्लोस दैट इज बर्मन्स मास्टरपीस ये मिस्टर बर्मन का मास्टरपीस है ही पेंटेड इन द नाइट ही इन द नाइट द लास्ट लीफ फेल सो जब लास्ट लीफ फॉल हो गई देन Berman went there and he painted it in the extreme rain and that saved your life. So indirectly he actually saved your life by sacrificing his life. Right? Understood? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that is the end of the chapter. Yes, so we can have a small discussion quickly. What is Jhansi's illness? Speak. Bolenge sab log. It is not like that chat mein nahi likhoge. Jo bolega wo khud ka. Who is answering? Karthik is answering. What is John C's illness?
Ma'am, pneumonia.
Ma'am, may I tell?
Yeah, Sanskar, go ahead.
Ma'am, John C is suffering from the pneumonia and she is not becoming well because of his unwillingness.
Right.
Unwillingness on the leaf that if he, the leaf felt, he is also dead, and that is not a truth.
Right. Do you think the feeling of depression John C has is common among teenagers? What do you think? You all are teenagers. You can tell it.
Yes, ma'am, because of pressure.
Pressure of so many things, right, Tanish? And which kind of pressure you people usually feel?
To become successful.
The pressure of success, right? Getting good marks. Usually the academic pressure you people have on your shoulders and on your head, you feel like that you are burdened against all this, right? That is very common among. John C would have at that time pressure hoga kuch aisa yahan pe depression kaisa tha because she was not well or she had somehow connected her life with that ivy creeper and with the leaves of it she found herself connected with it. So Bowman has a dream. What is it? Does it come true?
Yes, ma'am. He painted the last leaf which saved John C's life.
Right. The masterpiece was that. He has a dream to paint a masterpiece. And it comes true in the form of the last leaf that ultimately saved the life of John C. Okay. What is Bowman's masterpiece? That's the same answer. What makes Sue say so?
Ma'am, the leaf he draw.
That he painted.
That he painted, ma'am. The Sue say so because his paint. Sue say was
is his masterpiece. Oh, sorry.
Because his painting saved the life of John C.
And that is why it is called
master.